Antonio Ruge presents Dry Inert Gas Generator Part 1.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. After discussing general knowledge about inert gas system, let's burst into dry inert gas generator, the most complicated and high technology among other inert gas system. Unlike traditional wet system, a dry inert gas generator produces ultra clean, moisture free gas to preventing corrosion, reducing maintenance and keeping crews and cargo protected. In this video, we will outline the parts that make up dry inert gas generator and its function with clear animation showing its internal parts. Are you ready to enter dry inert gas generator journey? Get strapped in because the journey begins now. Let's go.
IGG part name and function. Dry inert gas generator is the equipment to produce low moisture or low humidity inert gas. Dry inert gas prevents ice formation and chemical degradation of the cargo, commonly used for gas carrier which is operating at cryogenic temperatures. Here is list of common dry inert gas generator parts along with their functions. Seed chest drainer to filter debris and marine organisms from seawater before it enters the ship's seawater systems. IGG seawater pump to supply seawater to scrubber for cooling and flue gas washing purposes. IGG fuel pump to transport fuel oil from a storage tank to the burner. IGG scrubber unit. Burner as a mixing device between fuel oil, air, and atomizing steam. Atomizing steam control valve to regulate the amount of steam used for atomizing fuel oil. Combustion chamber outer cell. The outer cell to prevent heat radiation from combustion chamber to outside. Combustion chamber inner cell. The inner cell acts as a heat retainer and as a barrier to the jacket cooling water. Main burner used as the primary burner to burn fuel by atomizing the fuel into droplets with a nozzle. Steam heater to reheat the supplied saturated steam for atomizing the fuel in the main burner. Combustion sprayer. Spray water cools the hot flue gas, making it easier to condense and capture pollutants. Water droplets trap and remove fine particles and soot from the exhaust stream. Scrubber sprayer to cool down temperature of flue gas by using seawater spray in the opposite direction of the flue gas. Scrubber demister to remove entrained liquid droplets or mist from the gas stream exiting the combustion chamber. These droplets typically contain water, chemicals, or pollutants contained in the flue gas. Scrubber tower, the unit for capture, cool, and remove pollutants, dust, or particulate matter from flue gas. Pilot burner, a small flame that ignited electrically. It serves to ignite the main burner. Thank you. IgG blower unit. IgG blower. The blower is two stage type. Blower operates in the medium pressure range. It is to provide the required air to fuel ratio to ensure efficient combustion in the combustion chamber. IgG chiller unit. Glycol circulation pump to circulate cool glycol water from chiller to cooler. Glycol expansion tank to accommodate the expansion of fluid when it heats up and to maintain system pressure within safe limits. Chiller condenser to cool down and condense refrigerant gas into a high pressure liquid. Chiller compressor to circulate the refrigerant and increase its pressure and temperature. This allows the cycle to continue and enables effective heat transfer. Chiller evaporator to absorb heat from the space or substance that needs to be cooled. It is when the refrigerant evaporates or boils by absorbing thermal energy. IgG cooler unit. IgG cooler to cool down wet inert gas delivered from scrubber, also for removing moisture through condensation. Oxygen analyzer to measure the concentration of oxygen from generated inert gas. IgG cooler tube to exchange heat from inert gas to chilled glycol water. IgG cooler demister to remove entrant liquid droplets or mist from cool inert gas. IgG control panel. IgG control panel to operate and monitor IgG from local site. It contains LCD panel, start and stop button, alarm indicator and light indicator, and so on. Thank you. IGG dryer unit. ADS dryer tower, the tower for storage alumina beads. There are two ADS dryer towers, which work in alternation. Alumina beads. Its function as a desiccant that adsorbs the water vapor from the inner gas. Regeneration cooler to cool down regenerate air after ADS dryer absorbent regeneration. Regeneration cooler tubes. The tubes filled with cooling water to exchange heat from regeneration air. Steam regeneration heater to heat up regeneration air using steam for regeneration alumina or absorbent. Steam regeneration heater tubes, heating tubes using steam for heat exchange between regeneration air and steam. Electric regeneration heater coils, heating coils using electric heater for heating up regeneration air. Electric regeneration heater to heat air to a high temperature to drive out moisture or contaminants that have been absorbed by desiccants using electric source. Regeneration steam heater control valve to regulate amount of steam used for regeneration steam heater. Regeneration blower to supply or recirculate regeneration air. IGG dryer control panel. Dryer control panel, the panel for controlling dryer operation. IGG discharge line. check valve or non-return valve to prevent back pressure from cargo tank or hold space to engine room. Supply valve to hold space, to supply inner gas or dry air to cargo tank hold space. Supply to vapor line and supply to liquid line to be used for supplying inner gas or dry air to cargo tanks. Normally, this line is isolated with a blind plate and the connecting pipe is removed. Fan mesh to safely release gases or vapors from tanks or system into the atmosphere at a safe height and location. Cargo tank hold space is the enclosed area surrounding the LNG cargo tanks inside the hull of the ship. It provides physical protection, insulation support, and safety features for the cargo containment system. Cargo tank is a specially designed insulated container used to store and transport liquefied natural gas at very low temperature, approximately -162 degrees Celsius, and low pressure during sea transport.
This is the end of Dry Inert Gas Generator Part 1. I will continue this journey to explain how this unit works in Part 2. With animated flow of Dry Inert Gas Generator, you will feel like watching and learning from the actual machines. I appreciate every support from you that motivates me to keep sharing knowledge about marine engineering. And if you find this video useful, don't keep it to yourself. Share it with others so they can benefit as well. See you in my another video. Bye bye.
If you are loving this deep dive into the world of marine engineering, don't forget to hit that like button. It helps more people discover this ocean power stories. And if you want to keep sailing with us through more epic contents, subscribe and ring the bell so you never miss a voyage.
Thank you for watching my video. Terima kasih. The Antonio Project.